I'm Roger Romanelli. I'm a resident of Hillside, Illinois, and I'm joined today by Woodrick and Ruben Frias. And together with others, we are the Hillside Neighbors Community Group. We're asking you, all of our fellow residents in Hillside, and everyone across Illinois to join us in making the Illinois Prairie Path safer and nicer for everyone to enjoy. Here is our plan to improve the Illinois Prairie Path, and it's shown in the color of green. And it is our goal to make the Prairie Path shorter, safer, and in the process, don't overspend our Illinois taxes. And let me say this, our plan calls for making under $1 million of improvements to the Prairie Path in order to solve the dangerous conditions in Hillside today. But by comparison, Governor Pritzker and Mayor Tamburino, they want to spend millions and millions that we estimate at around $15 million. Myself, Amy, Ruben, and all of you, our money belongs to us. Our government officials can't overspend our money and can't waste our taxes. We're asking everyone to go to our website, hillsideneighbors.com, and join us at future events to improve the Illinois Prairie Path. And we thank you.
Hi, my name is Amy Woodrick. I am, as Roger introduced me, I've been a resident of this village my entire life, watched my children grow up, now watching my grandchildren grow up. We've ridden this bike trail. And some of the concerns I have as a grandparent and a parent, I don't like the safety measures that the mayor has proposed with the new bike trail. I feel like it's an unsafe way to go. I think he's going to be spending too much money, interrupting business, putting people in an unsafe place. And I think the proposed plan that we have in the green is much safer. It avoids streets, it avoids a lot of traffic, and it will keep our pedestrians and bicyclists and other people safe. And also being a nurse in rehabilitation, I feel like it's better as from an American Disability Act perspective as well. I feel like the proposed trail that the mayor has put in will put more people at risk, whereas the one that we propose will be much safer and much more protected for our citizens. Thank you. I'm Amy Woodrick. I'm a resident of Hillside, as Roger had introduced me. And I've been a resident in Hillside my whole life. I've ridden the Prairie Path. I know the Prairie Path. And I'm a little concerned about the proposal the mayor has put in. The red line, which outlines the way he wants to go, is basically not a safe route. I feel like there's too much traffic flow, there's too many streets, there's too many driveways. And for the children, for those who walk, who ride their bikes, for those who are elderly and maybe even disabled, it would not be a safe route for them to go. Keeping it unworn would keep it safer. It would protect our children. It would protect our elderly. It would protect our bicyclists and pedestrians. And it also keeps it off the main traffic flow. I feel like it would also be less costly if we kept it where it's kind of at right now, just making a few small improvements rather than a major improvement as Major Tamburino wants to do. But I really am concerned about the children for the most part. I'm really concerned that you're going to put kids on a bike trail where they're going to be riding along trucks and cars and motorcycles and people who don't pay attention to traffic, going in and out of some of our retail spots, going up and down the side streets. So I'm hoping we can get some help here. We really don't want the proposal. We want to keep it the way we have it. So thank you.
Yes, my name is Ruben Frias. And I'm a resident here in Hillside, and I virtually live right here on the Prairie Path. The Prairie Path is safe, but it can be much, much more safer. The residents of this side of the Prairie Path, we want to continue having the Prairie Path here. Our children have access to it. The residents here, they love it. They go walking in the evenings with their children, with their grandfathers, grandparents, and all the other things. Not only that, but they even have access to the library here in Hillside. And you see a lot of the children, they actually walk to, because it's nice to walk to the Prairie Path, and here they're gonna go and do some kind of research at the library. And it's nice that they can actually go somewhere safe. They don't have to be driven or transported there, where they can actually walk there and enjoy the walk. Like everybody else. And this is something that we want to stay with. We want to stay here on Warren Avenue. And believe me, we can do something and achieve something great here for all the residents of Illinois, as well as the residents of Hillside. Thank you. Yes, my name is Ruben Frias. I'm a resident here in Hillside, and actually I live on the Prairie Path. My children were raised here in Hillside. I've lived here for 30 years. My children were safe. They used it, they enjoyed it, and so did all their friends. This community here has enjoyed it for several years. It's safe. It can be safer, a little bit safer. I think it's important that everybody know that the residents want it here. They're used to it. They use it. They use it with their children. They use it with their in-laws. You see them in the evenings, walking up and down the streets, going for a walk, enjoying the day, enjoying the evening, talking about what they did. You know what, let's continue these things. And the proposal that the mayor and the governor is proposing, it's very unsafe to where they want to, in the direction that the Prairie Path would go. The safest way, the most direct way, is right here on Ward. Let's keep it here. So I hope that the mayor is listening. I hope that the governor is listening. And hopefully we'll get some action from them. And hopefully they'll talk to us. And we can come to an agreement. This is about everybody, the state of Illinois, the Prairie Path, for everybody, not only the residents of Hillside, but for the bicyclists that they come through the Prairie Path. They should be safe also. Everybody should be safe. Thank you.
Hi, I want to thank Amy and Ruben. I want to thank all of you for watching this video. We as the Hillside Neighbors are asking you to join us to bring the best safety and the most affordable way to fix the Prairie Path. We're asking you as residents across Illinois to visit our website, hillsideneighbors.com, that's hillsideneighbors.com, send us an email, sign our petition to Governor Pritzker, and help us tell the governor the Prairie Path must be safe for everyone, especially our seniors, our children, and people with disabilities. And we tell the governor, our money is our money, and any tax dollar has to be spent wisely. Our plan spends wisely. The governor, Governor Pritzker and Mayor Tamburino, they're talking about not spending our money wisely, and that can't happen. Again, please visit hillsideneighbors.com, and let's improve the Prairie Path. Thank you, everybody. Hi, we're at the first critical piece of improving the Illinois Prairie Path in Hillside. I'm here at the intersection of Butterfield Road, which runs this way, and Forest Avenue, which runs north and south. Butterfield is an Illinois main road. It's almost like a local highway. You have thousands of vehicles every day. Forest Avenue is a residential street and a neighborhood street. So the question is, how do we improve the Prairie Path safely at this intersection? Today, as you see over my shoulder, the Prairie Path crosses here over Forest Avenue at Butterfield. And our community group has worked very hard to put in a pedestrian safety crossing sign and flashing yellow lights. We believe that the essential safety improvement at this intersection is a three-way traffic signal. This provides the safest way for Prairie Path users to cross, safest way to slow down and calm traffic. The other huge advantage, this creates a brand new safe path for hundreds of students at Proviso West High School to get to school every day. Now, by contrast, Governor Pritzker and Mayor Tamburino want to do something that we think is very dangerous. If we pan here to my left, they want to put the Prairie Path along the north side of Butterfield Road and create a brand new 10-foot wide parkway along Butterfield Road. Why is that dangerous? The Prairie Path users, number one, have to go through multiple driveways on the street on Butterfield. Then they have to cross intersections, and ultimately they have to cross one of the most dangerous intersections in Illinois at Manheim and Washington. Our plan avoids putting the Prairie Path users on the north side of Butterfield. Our plan keeps the Prairie Path users in the safe residential neighborhood. And the last piece, this illustrates perfectly that we, the Hillside Neighbors Group, want to save your Illinois taxes. We don't believe that our government officials should be constructing pathways at a high cost. All of the infrastructure has to be moved. We believe the path can be made safer and more affordably by crossing here at Forest and Butterfield with a traffic signal and then creating protective bicycle lanes into the residential neighborhood and ultimately a bridge over Mannheim Road. We hope you'll agree with us. We hope you'll come out and look at this issue. Again, visit our website, hillsideneighbors.com. Hi, we're here at the second key point of the Prairie Path that shows the difference between what the Hillside Neighbors Community Group wants and what Governor Pritzker and Mayor Tamburino want. I'm standing here at the intersection, roughly at the intersection of Washington Street here, and to my left is Mannheim Road. I first want to show you the governor and the mayor want our Prairie Path bicycles to come along the north side parkway here of Washington Street. And if they did, children, senior citizens, and people in wheelchairs, people with disabilities, would have to drive through this car wash parking lot that you see right here. So as these cars enter and flow through the car wash, children and everybody on their bikes would have to contest with them. Now, coming over here near me, we have the CVS Pharmacy, which is a very busy business in Hillside. Again, under the governor and the mayor's plan, the children and people with disabilities and seniors would have to go through that busy driveway there. Our plan eliminates all these busy driveways. And then, really, the most dangerous of all, this intersection to my left here is the intersection of Washington Street and Mannheim Road in Hillside on one side and Bellwood on the other side. Ladies and gentlemen, this is one of the most dangerous intersections in all of Illinois. As we'll keep the camera here, you will see that this intersection of Washington and Mannheim has left turns, right turns, right turns on red allowed. You're seeing high volumes of vehicles. And of course, during the week, we're seeing high volumes of trucks. We may see some trucks here in the camera shop, but this is on a Saturday when we're not seeing as many trucks. During the weekday, when trucks are operating at this intersection, we're seeing hundreds and hundreds of trucks every day. Ask yourself, do you want your child? Do you want a senior citizen? Do you want someone who's a person with disabilities to cross this very dangerous intersection of Washington and Mannheim? This is what Governor Pritzker and Mayor Tamburino want. This is not what the Hillside Neighbors Community Group wants. We believe the most important element of protecting the Prairie Path is never to cross this intersection at Mannheim Road and Washington Street. And we hope you'll agree. Thank you. Good. Hi, we're at the third most critical piece of the Illinois Prairie Path in Hillside and Bellwood. As you see to my right, this is the Mannheim Road, one of the busiest roads in all of Illinois with heavy vehicle and truck traffic. Under the governor and the mayor's plan, stop right there, Suresh. Under the governor and the mayor's plan, the Prairie Path would continue right here along the west side of Mannheim Road, okay? So you would essentially have to construct a 10-foot wide path in the parkway and sidewalk area on Mannheim Road. You would have to drive through busy driveways. You would have to come down Mannheim and contest with all of this traffic. Think about it. Do you want your senior citizens, children, people with disabilities coming down Mannheim Road, going through these busy driveways, Firestone Vehicle Center over here, grocery stores, all of these driveways on Mannheim Road? That is not the safest way to fix the Prairie Path. Our plan avoids all of these driveways, and it avoids staying on Mannheim Road. Behind me here is the connector path to Bellwood. So that is Bellwood on the east side of Mannheim. We're here in Hillside on the west side of Mannheim. Our vision to solve the Prairie Path safety crisis is very simple. Right here at this intersection, We put a traffic signal immediately. Why is this important? This gives the Prairie Path user the shortest, safest, and quickest route to go right across Mannheim Road. There's no question that we can stop traffic here with a traffic signal, but ultimately, we build a bridge, a Prairie Path bridge over Warren, over Mannheim Road here at Warren, like Lombard, Highland Park, and other villages have done. This is what would make the Prairie Path the safest to build this bridge over Mannheim. Now, if the camera can come back here to my left, under the governor and the mayor's plan, not only would their Prairie Path be on the west side of Mannheim Road, but it would continue beyond the stop sign all the way down to Madison Street. Can you imagine our Prairie Path users along, right along Mannheim Road with all of this heavy traffic and then having to cross the Madison and Mannheim intersection? That is unsafe. It is costly, and it risks our lives, and it risks the welfare of people using the Prairie Path. Again, Mannheim Road, one of the busiest roads, vehicles and trucks in Illinois. We must avoid a path on Mannheim Road. Let's go directly over Mannheim Road here at Warren. Let's keep the path on Warren Avenue. We keep everyone safe. Thank you. Hi, we're here at the fourth critical piece of the Illinois Prairie Path and the decision for Illinois voters and residents about how the best way to fix the path. This is Warren Avenue and Hillside that extends from Mannheim in front of me all the way down to Forest Avenue to the west. This has been the home of the Prairie Path since 1963, and ladies and gentlemen, it is one of the safest parts of the entire Illinois Prairie Path. Why? As you see here, Warren Avenue is not does not have through cross streets. In other words, most of these residential streets are T intersections that basically dead end right into Warren. So what's great about Warren is it's a protected street. You're not having through traffic. That's number one. Number two, the only way to get on the Prairie Path from Elmhurst, let's say on the west, back to Maywood on the east, you have to cross Mannheim Road. The safest possible way is to keep it right here on Warren Avenue. What do we want to do as the Hillside neighbors? Very simple. We want to paint a 10-foot wide protected bicycle lane on the north side of Warren. No parking, and in that bicycle lane, we protect it with bollards, whether they're metal or more durable, but we protect the bicyclists here on Warren Avenue. If we can do that and make a two-way bike lane 10 feet wide, this will be the safest piece of the entire Illinois Prairie Path. Because again, there's no through vehicles. Warren is a residential street at 20 miles an hour compared to Butterfield at 30 and Mannheim at 35. We have families, and as you see, we've got families here who care about the Prairie Path. They want to keep the path on Warren. There's no park in this neighborhood for the children and families. And then as you come here over my left shoulder, this is where we want to build a Prairie Path park so that Prairie Path users coming from the east or the west, and this is also a park for the neighborhood, will be able to relax, will be able to take their shoes off, have some lunch. It's a natural open lot right here on the Prairie Path. Another opportunity for green space and another opportunity to enhance the Prairie Path. So the safest way to help improve the Prairie Path is to keep it right here on Warren Avenue and Hillside.